Now, we're doing this little masterclass session right now about certain punches. And we're going to be looking today at the left hook. Now, you said that your, you know, left hook is your speciality punch, your favourite punch. Why is it the left hook?
I wouldn't say it was my speciality punch. I was taught that all the greatest fighters follow through.
Yeah.
And I remember Brian Hughes always telling me, you know, I watched Sugar Ray Robinson, I watched fighters like Sugar Ray Leonard, even Tommy Hearns. When Tommy Hearns threw the right hand, he'd come out with the left hook.
Yeah.
Ray Robinson threw his left hook, he used to triple up on it, it was phenomenal, he'd always come back.
Yeah, yeah.
So most of the fighters today are very one-dimensional, they don't follow through. So basically, if you used to throw a left hook to the body, you bring it to the head. If you throw a left hook to the head, you go to the body. And that's how you catch people.
Now, you say follow, when you say follow through, what do you mean? Can you show us what you mean when you mean when you say follow through?
That's kind of, yeah. So the famous right, so I'd go there, most fighters there would either take one step back,
yeah,
catch you going back.
Yeah.
They don't expect that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because once again, as you see it there now, and if it was the other way around, if I threw the left hook, step back, I catch with the right hand. So you always catch them because most people when on the retreat, they always step back with their hands down.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And they always think. And when I fought Tony Willis, for instance, for the British title, what I did with Tony Willis is I threw the right hand, as he laid back, I caught him with a long left hook going back because he laid back.
Yeah.
As he laid back, the only way you can go back from there is forward.
Yeah.
But as he laid back from the right hand, yeah,
that's when you caught him going.
And as long left hook, bam, sweeping it across.
Yeah.
That's what caught him.
Is the left hook the easiest hook? Which generates the most power? Is it the left hook?
It's basically it's how you motivate your body.
Right.
So most people when they punch, you just go.
Yeah.
But if you try, you turn into it. Now you see how you can come up with the left hook. But not like that. Not with your hand down there. See there. Now you can see the way I've turned.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can come up with the left hook.
Yeah. Okay. So your whole body there, momentum.
It's all about heel.
Yeah.
See, most people when see, without giving too much away, see, most fighters, when I train them, the movement should be covered, so it's more like, that's how you're boxing.
Yeah.
But now put it there for left hook.
Yeah.
You can punch up that movement.
Yeah.
Because I'm just disguising that, just how I'm boxing now. And that's what you're waiting for it.
Yeah.
And then,
bang.
Yeah. And that's also the same with the right hand.
All right,
yeah?
Okay.
Or, let's say the left hook to the body.
Go on, let me see the left hook to the body.
So put the hand down there. So it's there now, if I'm moving, yeah, and put a jab in, flip, bam.
Oh, yeah.
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 So that's what I'm saying.
Oh, yeah. I'm glad I only just had breakfast. That was nice. So, earlier as well, you mentioned to me something interesting. You mentioned to me about thinking fighters.
Yeah.
Fighters thinking. I know that's a big thing for you as well. So, what, you know, is it about setting up the right shot? Is that about thinking your way into the shot?
Once again, it goes off this. This is you thinking.
Yeah.
That's you thinking because while you're doing that,
yeah,
the opponent's thinking, what's he going to do?
Yeah.
And then you're just there, you're just, and you're just waiting there.
Yeah, I got you.
You know what I'm saying?
So
you're not already anticipating where you're going to go.
Okay.
Because off that movement, if they don't like that movement and they step forward, you just step back, tap, tap.
Okay.
Yeah? So you're always, it's like a self-insurance. You're reassured. This here is what you're doing in training. Yeah?
Yeah.
The fact, like you watch Terence Crawford.
Yeah.
Like what a fighter he is.
Great fighter.
That's what a thinking fighter is. Mm. He does it all in the gym, on the bags, on the pads, and inspiring. It doesn't change.
Yeah.
It just keeps getting better and better and better and better and better till it becomes to say, where, how do you get a blueprint to beat this guy? It's really hard.
Yeah.
Yeah. Even another thinking fighter, right? It's like Mayweather.
Mm-hmm.
Mayweather is absolutely brilliant at what he does.
Mm.
It doesn't change what he does, it just comes better and better and better.
And even when you're waiting against thinking fighters like Mosley, people like that, they still couldn't work him out.
Yeah, because it's hard. But it's the same as Sugar Ray Robinson.
Yeah.
Sugar Ray Robinson used to spend hours just being in the mirror, simple little things, just practicing, be staying side on, moving, certain little things like that. And them little things play a big part in your boxing.
Okay.
And people don't see that.
Yeah.
You know, it's not just about the hard work in the gym and the circuits. Basically, how many trainers tell a fighter, listen, prepare your mind for this fight?
Yeah.
Train your mind. It's okay telling them to do it. I mean, tell them to do it, but how are you going to teach them how to do it?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's what I've been telling Delphi from being an amateur.
Yeah. So would you say ring IQ is actually equally, if even more important than developing the fundamentals of boxing, the ring IQ, yeah.
And that exactly because your IQ tells you what you're going to do. It's like when you get up in the morning, your brain tells you what you're going to do. Yeah. You don't just say, oh, well, walk around and do this. You say, right, get up in the morning, first people, some people blow the nose, some people go to the toilet.
Yeah.
People have set routines what to do. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Right? Yeah. I know what I'm going to do. So when I get in the ring and I come to train, I know what I want to work on.
Yeah.
Right? And it's what I install now in all my fighters.
Yeah.
I say, look, the only thing is you say you got a good trainer. No, a good trainer wants a good fighter. They complement each other. So if I've got a fighter that comes in the gym and says, listen, I want you to teach me, I'm prepared to learn, I want to do anything what you say, I'll look at him and thinking, am I dreaming?
Yeah.
Is that true?
Yeah.
And I'll put him through the test.
Okay.
Yeah. And that's what it is. They give 100%, I give 100%. We complement each other. There's no such thing as a good trainer. Yeah. Because you've got to always remember, a trainer doesn't do the fighting, the fighter does. So how can you be a good trainer to make the fighter do what you want to do? There's a lot of trainers that say he doesn't listen. He's not doing what I want him to do. Why is that?
Yeah.
Why is that?
Yeah. Why is that, yeah?
You've got to slowly but break it down, teach them. You can't stop until they've got it in every possible way.
Yeah.
Even if I was to shout, scream and swear, it ain't going to tell them. Yeah. I've got to teach them. Yeah. So I have to find things that I can say. For instance, I say your jab's got to be like a snake's tongue.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you create, you imagine what a snake's tongue is.
Yeah.
That's
your
jab.
Yeah.
So you have to draw certain pictures.
Certain analogies, yeah.
Yes, to give them. It's like with kids. When you've got a little kid and you teach them and you want to say ball, you show them a ball and then you tell them how to write it. Yeah. You're showing them square. You're teaching them as you go along. That's how you set the mind. Yeah. That's how you program a file. What's very hard to me, what I always find the hardest, is when they've come from somewhere else. Under the gym. Now you've got to reinstall something into a fighter that nobody else has not done before.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's come here to learn. Okay, cool. I'm going to teach you.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed that video, leave your comments below. We love hearing your opinion, and also remember to hit that subscribe button. See you next time.